That was a funny video and all, but you know, lately, man, it's just all about glorifying God with your body, as Paul commands, you know, because we are those who believe in Christ, those who are his followers. One second. Those who are his followers. Hold on, let me fix this. Yeah, those who are his followers, you know, those who believe, has received him as Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, you know, we are the temples of the Holy Spirit. So we should glorify God in our bodies, you know what I mean? Lately, you know, I joke around and stuff, but it's a serious matter, you know what I mean? You know, I just been thinking, you know, I'm about to be 30 next month, so I'm like, you know, I've been having like breathing issues and stuff like that. You know, just eating bad, you know what I mean? But man, like lately blood pressure been crazy, you know what I mean? It's just been high, you know? So, soon as I started seeing how it was affecting me, I was like, oh no, you know, cause I don't want to die young, you know? You know, I want God to finish the good work he started in me, which he will, you know, but I do believe it could be cut short, you know, by how I'm eating, you know what I mean? And I don't wanna die young, you know what I mean? And I wanna finish doing what God made me here to do, you know, until he calls me home, you know? So I wanna read a few scriptures. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 19 and 20, but I'll give you the context of the whole message of this from verse 12. You know, it talks about fleeing sexual immorality. Paul talking about all things are lawful for me, but not all things are helpful. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything, you know, and all foods are available. But all foods, you know, are not good for me, especially if I'm overdoing it, you know what I mean? But yeah, you know, because we, you know, we pray over the food, we pray over the food and it's blessed, you know what I mean? I truly do believe that, but it shouldn't get to the point where that's all I'm eating, that's all, you know, he talks about joining yourself with a prostitute, you know, basically sex before marriage, how you become one with her, and how now we who believe are now one. It says, but he who is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. And this is verse 17. I just read 17 to 20. Flee from sexual immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body. But the sexually immoral person sins against his own body. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own. For you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. You know, that's what it is. You know, we here to be good stewards of what we have. Whether it's financially, whether it's our wife, our kids, you know what I mean? Whatever we have a responsibility over, we're called to be good stewards over it. Manage everything correctly, you know, manage it right. Be wise, you know. James talks about if you don't have wisdom, look, just ask the Lord. He'll give you the wisdom for it. But also, I'm going to go to Romans chapter 12. Verse 1, which is a really good one as well. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Holy and acceptable. Present them. You know, God wants to use our body. You know, we're the temple. This is the temple of the Holy Spirit living inside of us, but we're the temple. We're you know, basically the church house, basically. We're the house of the Holy Spirit, you know, so just, and I'm talking to myself too, be encouraged. Remember that, you know, it's not a lot of sermons on gluttony and eating better, you know. It's not a lot of sermons on that. We always have fat pastors and stuff like that, fat ministers, you know, and hopefully that wasn't offensive. Dang it, I said it. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it like that, but yeah, you know, it's just, we always have out of shape pastors and ministers, and, you know, there's never, preach salvation for sure, but there should be definitely, you know, the encouragement should always be in all things, whether in eat or drink, to glorify God, you know, in all that we do. And I think that's 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. But yeah, you know, and if anybody got high blood pressure, this is what I've been doing lately. Just have a balanced diet, you know. Sometimes, like, when I set my mind to something, I'm going all the way in. But, you know, I learned to just balance it out. You know what I mean? And the thing is, we have a foundation. We have a beautiful foundation. We have Jesus Christ, our Lord. So we have the motivation of what, why we want to, you know, eat right or whatever, do better in our diet. We have the motivation, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ who strengthens us through this, who we depend on, who's our foundation we build off of. So I have Braggs, you know what I'm saying, the mother. But yep, this helps. You know what I do, I like to drink this. You know, I don't like to mix it with my water because I like my waters to taste the same. But what I do, take the cap off, and me, it's like a 40. I just drink it. and I drink it, and, you know, keep it in my mouth for a little bit, and then follow up with the water. It's like a chaser. So that's good. That helps keep the blood pressure down. I wish I knew how to edit some things out, but I'm just gonna be raw. But yep, you take this first. Take this about 2-3 times a day, the apple cider vinegar. You know, I do it in the morning, probably lunch, and around dinner time or whatever. But it helps out a lot. It helps out with weight loss as well. So, and while you're having that balanced diet, also try to get in the habit of working out. You know, just taking care of this temple, this beautiful temple that God given us. And just glorify God in it, you know. And you'll be all right. And just pray every day. You know, if you don't feel like it, just go for a walk. Even if you don't feel like working out, just get loose. Just walk. Run something, you know, because God's not done with you, you know. So keep going, and hope y'all encouraged. God bless.